Hi guys. So today on this busy Sunday afternoon, I'm with somebody who's got 11 years of experience, somebody who is a corporate chef and an R&D executive at Wanet Commune, a lover and a passionate for Uttarakhand cuisine. With me, I have Chef Pawan Bish, with whom I'm going to share a lot of stories. So hi Chef.
Hi, welcome to Wanet.
Thank you. So tell me Pawan, how did you get into this entire experience of cooking? How was your childhood memories?
So I'm from a very small village by the name of Chhoi, which is next to Corbett National Park in Uttarakhand.
Okay.
And there's a huge impression of my mom into my cooking.
Wow.
How and why? Because you know, I'm from that place which has developed in few, or you can say in recently past few years. So I still remember when I was in class 7th or 8th, at that point of time we got the electricity in our village.
Mm-hmm.
So I've seen those like, you know, drastic changes, like when you see all these funny things or funny videos or funny episodes where people say there used to be a single television in the village and everybody used to go and watch Ramayana, which used to be a very big hit at that point of time.
Correct.
So I've seen that entire, you know, because we used to be so backward. So I've seen my mom cooking or mother cooking into desi, on those desi chulas also. And then there a time came when this thing, gobar gas.
Mm-hmm.
So there's still a plant of gobar gas in at my house.
Wow.
So then they started cooking on that gobar gas chulas and all those things. And then time came when LPG came.
Correct.
So she has seen the entire change in her entire life and career.
Mm-hmm.
As a, we can say not career, like in entire her life journey. And so she has cooked on stones also, she has cooked on chulas also, she has cooked on gobar gas also, she has cooked on LPG also.
Mm-hmm.
So when I was like say in class 11th or 12th, so I asked mom, you know, like, don't you feel irritated, like, you know, ki kabhi is pe khana, kabhi us pe khana and those things. So she was like, you know, she said one thing to me, ki beta, you just need heat, aapko bas aanch chahiye, khana to pakke jata hai. So if you can control the heat, you can cook whatever you want. So that's how it started. And then I got selected in one of the prestigious colleges in India, IHM Mumbai. And I was lucky to be learning from Chef Vandan Kollo. And yeah, so that's how it started. And then I joined Olive and it started and keep going. And now I'm all thankful to Mr. Ankit Dayal, who is like, you know, who is man behind all these projects which I am doing right now, Wanet Commune or Veranda or everything. So yeah, so that's how it started, and here we are today.
Alright. So as a young boy, I think your mother influenced you a lot.
A lot.
So what was the first dish that you remember or recall that your mother created for you?
So it was a weird thing. See, there's a dish or an ingredient, you can say. It is known as a stinging nettle, commonly known as sisoor ka saag. So what happens, like, you know, it has poisonous substances in it. So if it touches you, it started, it will, you know, it will start itching.
Oh.
So we, not me, any person and everybody who stays in hilly areas, mm-hmm, or this Himalayan belt, this sisoor, you can find it from Himachal till, you know, Nepal and all those things, all these areas.
Okay.
Till northeast states of India. So they used to scare us of sisoor ka saag, of sisoor ka this thing plant.
Mm-hmm.
So they used to say, behave yourself or aapko sisoor ka this thing, we'll touch it with the sisoor. So that was a scary thing, but you know, that plant is such a nutritious and healthy plant that it cures so many things and so many diseases and all those things. So we make a vegetable preparation known as sisoor ki sabzi.
Okay.
And I got scared ki why they are asking me to eat sisoor, because in our mind it was like, you know, ye to itching karta hai. So if I'll eat sisoor ka saag, it will go in my stomach, and then how will I scratch inside my stomach? And I'm a country boy, so being a country boy, it gives you, you know, like, you have to go through so different things that it gives you a complete different experience, a learning experience, basically what I mean to say.
Mm.
So it gave me a complete learning experience. So at that age, I was wondering when I was class 6th or 7th or 5th or 6th, ki, why she is cooking banana, because banana is a fruit, or why she is cooking sisoor, which is stinging nettle, because it will go inside our stomach and it will start itching, and how will we, like, you know, itch, start itching from inside, like, you know, inside of our stomach. So these were, like, in a few stories, like, you know, that's how I developed my interest in cooking and learning about ingredients or traveling or like, whatever.
Correct. So at what age do you realize ki haan, aaj maine kuch bana liya and I want to become a chef? Wo ek platform
kab aaya? So So being from a very remote area or a small village, so every parent is like, you know, I'm not talking about my parent. I'm lucky to have such great parents. And I wish everyone should have like parents like mine. So so their dream was like, you know, okay, our kid will not stay here. We want him to go out and explore. So they sent me to a small town, name is Ramnagar, which is close to Corbett Park. So I used to stay alone with my friends for higher studies and all that. So I don't know whether they used to like, you know, what we call in Hindi ki chadate the and all those things. So they used to say, wah Pawan, kya khana banaya, wah Pawan. And I used to be like, chalo, let's cook for them or let's cook for myself and all those things. So karte karte karte, it became a habit ki, okay, every evening Pawan is cooking and all those things. And they are, I don't know whether it was real, they are telling truth or they were telling a false thing. Ki Pawan yaar tera haath mein jadoo hai, khana bahut acha banta hai, kehne ka matlab. So that's how it like, you know, started. Okay, theek hai, if they're enjoying, so might be there must be some reason they're saying and all those things. I still don't know ki whether they were like, you know, ki they were getting away from work, ki hame khana nahi banana padega and easy to be cooking, or it was a genuine thing.
Correct.
But today, like, I think ki they were saying the truth ki, okay, yeah, you have a very good hand in cooking.
Correct.
So that's how it started, and that's how like I searched and all things. I got selected for AIEEE also. So I got Panthinga University. And my, again, from a small, being from a school, everyone thinks, okay, your son should be an engineer, doctor, police, or like army and all those things. So again, a whole father-son fight happened, and he was like, no, you have to go and you have to do engineering. I want you to see as an engineer. And I was like, no, I want to go and I want to, you know, I want to cook. So he was so upset that he didn't talk to me like for almost 2 years.
Wow.
And I was also like, you know, his son, and I was like, you know, okay, I will do it myself. So we used to go as waiting. So Sumit, my friend, very dear friend, Spurs, Sumit, me, Anurag, so we used to go for waiting, and we used to get 200 or 300 rupees for 5-6 hours.
Oh.
So every day after doing college, without informing anyone, so we used to go and we used to do waiting in different people's house or marriages and all those things as a waiter. And that's how we used to earn our daily penny or daily basic money and all. So one day my mom was like, you know, what is wrong with you? Why don't you talk to him? He's not taking money from home. Is he into a wrong thing? How is he surviving and all those things? So then my dad called and he was like, you know, this, that, blah, blah. And that's how it got, like, you know, got sorted, and he got calm and he said, okay, I will support you, whatever you are doing. I'm proud of you because you have taken a decision and you are standing to that decision. So I will, like, you know, I respect you. So
like Pawan shared with us, dedication, having confidence in you, parents backing it up, everything comes up with hard work, everything comes up with time, everything comes up with persistence. So over 11 years, Pawan has achieved a lot. Let us see what Pawan has achieved now. So Pawan, after 11 years, how are you promoting your love for Uttarakhand cuisine?
So when this lockdown happened, and I went back, and you know, so we are, you can say I'm a workaholic. So all of a sudden when you get all these 3 hours and all those things, you know, you get, I was like, you know, I was confused, like, you know, I can't sit idle, what I'm doing, why I'm sitting idle and all those things. And what I've been noticing in past all these years with my experience is that, you know, I think Uttarakhand cuisine is one of the healthiest cuisine.
Okay.
And if you see, like, you know, that cuisine, that food is not only just a food thing, it helps you to cure also. So there are few dishes which I personally know, like for example, Rajada. So Rajada is a dish from Uttarakhand which is given to patients who are suffering from jaundice.
Okay.
So all like, you know, in earlier days, there was hardly means of communication and transport in high rises of the Himalayas and all this. So if somebody is suffering from jaundice, it will take that person to go down to the doctor, and it will take at least say 2 to 3 days to reach over there and 2 to 3 days to come back.
Okay.
Right? So that jaundice will become worse by the time.
Correct.
So that's how our ancestors and all those people and grandfathers and all those things, they developed all these food habits and these dishes which can cure these diseases. So Rajada is still a you can say Ayurvedic dish. You eat it and you will get cured without any artificial kind of medicine or anything. So it is a combination of red rice from Uttarakhand and pure desi ghee and a salt made with what we call pahari namak. And main thing is that bhat. So bhat is a black soybean basically.
Okay.
So it's a kind of khichdi which is eaten along with desi ghee and salt.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how they used to cure their jaundice, basically. So these, all these things, you know, I got fascinated from all these things because, like, you know, I was like, you know, ki we are aware of this thing. And this is one of the healthiest cuisine. Why other people are not getting benefited of this? So I started cooking at my hometown only, next to my house only, inside my house only, in my kitchen garden basically. So I started doing all, you know, country style methods. Like I created an entire chula and started cooking in that one. Then I made a proper bhatti. So bhatti, it's a tunnel kind of thing.
Okay.
And for example, this is the place. So you make a tunnel and the wood goes from here and the fire will come out from somewhere here. This thing, so there's a tunnel inside the soil or land, you can say. And so from where you put the log or whatever wood, so say a distance of 1.5 or 2 feet. So the fire will come out from a distance from
so
one.
This is underground.
This is underground, right? So that kind of cooking, and then made a proper oven. From proper, you can say, desi style oven to bake the pizzas and all this thing. So these are the primitive methods, you know, which our ancestors used to do, and that's how they used to retain the nutritional value of the food, and that's how it became, that's how this food became so healthy, I mean to say. What I have been noticing, there is no talk of Uttarakhand cuisine anywhere in entire India. So it was like, you know, it was worrying me ki why this healthiest cuisine is, like, you know, getting lost, or why all this, like, I personally found 12 or 13 recipes from my state which have already lost, I mean to say, and which are, like, you know, more of time consuming, and these dishes are, like, you know, these are into, like, hardcore Ayurvedic and you can say used for medicinal purposes, basically. So I don't want these dishes to go out or get lost. So that's how it entire thing started. And then when I started cooking, so I started getting calls ki, okay, you know, what happened? People were, like, you know, locked inside one room only. So I started getting calls ki, Pawan, you are doing a wonderful job, because, you know, you are in open and we can, you know, though we are inside a room, so we can assume ki, like, you know, or we can see that greenery and that open sky and all those things, and which is giving us a positive vibe, basically. So I was like, you know, okay, so I'm doing a double thing. So I'm like, you know, people are getting happy because of what I'm doing, and they are getting to see, like, you know, what they were habitual of, the open sky and everything. And second thing, it is giving me opportunity to to showcase the healthy cuisine of Uttarakhand. So that's how this entire thing started.
Okay.
Yeah, I want to showcase the Uttarakhand cuisine. And meanwhile, in between, I got a call from Uttarakhand Tourism Board also. And they were like, you know, you're doing a wonderful job and we want to take your content and everything. So again, that thing also boosted me. Okay, somebody is noticing. The government is noticing. And it gave me a boost. And then I never stopped. I mean, so entire 6 months I was into cooking Uttarakhand cuisine, basically.
Wow. So when you say Uttarakhand cuisine has so many positive points to it, it is healthy, it is nutritional, medicinal values. Why do you think that in our country this kind of cuisine is not promoted that much? And Uttarakhand is a big state.
I think, like, you know, more of this is all because of, you know, globalization, internet times and all those things. People want to look fancy, people want to eat fancy, right?
Correct.
But I think everything has an era or time period. So there was a time when, you know, there were like few restaurants in metropolitan cities which were big hit. Then their time came and they started growing like mushrooms.
Correct.
And now again, this time when everything is getting shut and, you know, new things are coming up, the business is, like, you know, going through a toss and all those things.
Right.
Similar pattern, there was a time when, you know, everyone was running behind European cuisine.
Correct.
Then their time came, everyone ran behind Japanese or Oriental cuisine.
Mm-hmm.
And now, like, you know, people have realized what they're taking, what we say, Indian cuisine to a next level.
Correct.
So that's how it's building, and, you know, people are getting aware, and whatever has happened in the past 6 months, they have become more precautious or, you know, cautious, you know, those things.
Alright, so as we know, Uttarakhand cuisine has a lot of positive properties to it. It's famous, it's doing well. And Pawan is right now at Vanet Commune. So I want to know, after you have this sip from your
head, yeah,
I want to know, how did you come up with this entire menu of Vanet?
So,
and what is your favorite dish?
Yeah, so when Ankit Ayal, the owner, Mr. Ankit Ayal, So when he told me that, okay, we are going to open this place and we are going to head it. So he, like, you know, he explained few points what kind of venue he want. So as Virat, Mr. Virat Kohli, he is well traveled. He traveled across the globe. And he's a proper Delhi boy. And he had traveled a lot. And plus, you know, like he is into health thing, fitness, also, like, yeah, fitness thing also, right? So there should be, he was like, oh, there should be a menu which comprises everything, which is having everything. Like, you know, there is a, as he's a, which can showcase what Mr. Virat Kohli is like. He's a proper Delhi boy also. Uh-huh. So we have dishes like, you know, which Delhi people love, basically, like the butter chicken.
And Delhi people, right, are foodie.
Yeah, they are foodie. Yeah. So butter chicken and all those things, kind of dishes, they're this thing also in the menu. Then when it comes to his fitness side, mm-hmm, so we have few dishes like superfood salad, red and white quinoa salad and all those things.
Okay.
So there's a particular segment which we have covered that part of Virat's house.
Okay.
And then there's, like, you know, a story behind his, like, the way he travels a lot.
Uh-huh.
Suppose he's in Australia, so whatever food he's eating over there, whatever experience he's getting over there. Mm-hmm. So he shared, like, you know, few experiences and all those things. Okay. Like there's a dish by the name of Anticucho slider.
Okay.
So Anticucho it's a Peruvian sauce, basically,
okay,
or dip, you can say. So he loved that whenever he was in that city or like in that country.
Okay.
So he loved that particular kind of sauce or dip.
Mm-hmm.
So he told me that, you know, so there's a Anticucho kind of, you know, this thing.
Okay.
So what can you do with that? So I made few sliders out of that dip and sauce. So it's a combination of everything.
Okay.
So it is a combination of, like, you know, what Delhi people want, what Virat Kohli is, or the different sides of Virat Kohli, the traveling person, the fitness freak, the Delhi boy. So we have comprised, like, you know, the menu is like compilation of each and everything.
Okay.
So that's how that entire thing came into the picture.
Correct. Okay, so like he shared with us, Virat Kohli, as we all know, is an Indian cricket captain. Virat is a Delhi boy, he loves to eat, and he's a fitness freak as well. So when you created this menu, which is your personal favorite and which is Virat's personal favorite?
So there's this mushroom cream cheese and truffle oil dim sums. So it's my favorite also, and it's Virat's favorite also.
Okay.
And there are few other dishes, like, you know, when you go to the health side, I love red and white quinoa salad.
Mm-hmm.
It's a proper balanced and healthy plated dish.
Okay.
And then we are doing Napoli pizzas, so our pizzas are also very nice.
Okay.
And if you go towards the regional side, I love our coastal style Andhra chicken.
Uh-huh.
And I love our Five Rivers mud cake.
Okay.
Which is a layered mud cake, basically.
Okay.
And I love our tacos are also really nice.
Mm-hmm.
So if you see, again, it's a combination of different, like, tacos, something from different country, dim sums from different country, then there's regional thing also.
Uh-huh.
Oh, there's this thing, famous black chicken also. So it's a Assamese dish.
Okay.
And it is commonly known as Tildiya Murgi in Assam.
Okay.
And I love that dish. I just love that dish. It's a combination of black sesame seeds.
Uh-huh.
And garlic, mint, coriander and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So when you say black chicken, it's not basically Kadaknath. So there's a species,
right,
or kind of this thing in India which is entirely, the meat is completely black.
Correct.
So here the entire thing is, the black thing came out because of the black sesame seeds.
Okay.
So that's how the name came out, black chicken.
Okay.
And commonly in Hindi it's known as Tildiya Murgi.
Okay.
So yeah, so if you see, again, it's a combination of different food from different countries, different culture, different regions and everything. So that's how, like, you know, the menu is done, and these are the dishes which I love, basically.
Alright. So, wrapping up this conversation, what are your future projects and what is that we look forward in 21?
So, right now, Mr. Ankit Dayal, governor, so he is into expanding 18 Commune.
Mm-hmm.
So, we are coming up with 4 different restaurants, 18 Commune, at different places across India.
Okay.
And my personal plans is, like, you know, I'm going to open my own restaurant soon.
Okay.
And so that will be again based on Uttarakhand cuisine.
Okay.
Because I want to showcase the or I want to I want this thing that people should get benefited of these dishes.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I want these dishes to come out to metro cities. There, it is needed a lot.
Correct.
So, the cuisine itself, you know, is given to the people who are, if you see, there's the TV hospital or TV curing place in Uttarakhand itself, near next to Bhawali.
Yeah,
why? Because that environment and that food suits to cure TB. Mm. So I just want to, like, you know, get this cuisine to metropolitan cities so that people can, as you can see, these diseases are like really common these days. Say diabetes, high blood pressure, and all these. So why to heal with drugs or medicines when food can heal you?
Correct.
So my funda is that exactly the same funda that I want to get that cuisine over here so that people can get healed with the help of food, not the drugs. Yeah.
So this will be first of its kind.
Yeah, it will be first of its kind for sure. And plus there will be a few other outlets which I will be doing with Mr. Vinit Tusi, another partner or owner.
Uh-huh.
And we are into, you know, we are into all this procedure and of finding places and all those things already.
Okay.
And I will be coming soon with say 2-3 different projects and different restaurants.
All right. So all the best for that.
Thank you so much.
And with this, we got to know everything that Pawan has been achieving over the years. We know about his future plans. And the best part is he's going to come up with a project of introducing Uttarakhand cuisine, which is very, very useful for people because it has a very strong nutritional and medicinal values. With this, I wrap up Spotlight with KT, episode 3. Thank you.